Hello everyone, this is Magdalena, Wolf of Coins. Nice to see you all again. Today I wanted to share with you some thoughts about this deck. So, this is the Tarot de Marseille Restoration by Pablo Robledo. So, the name is Tarot de Marsella, Robledo. And it came in this wonderful wrap. I don't know if you can tell, but it's silvery white. And it says it's from Argentina. So yeah, I will be showing you all the cards, but I have some extra stuff here as well, because Pablo himself was so nice that he shared some of his inspirations with me. We chatted a bit. It was amazing. That's something I really love about this community. All those wonderful, talented, skilled card makers are so accessible, and you know, they are so full of passion that they want to just share with others. It's just wonderful. So Pablo, if you're watching, thank you so much. It's great. And I'm just checking if I'm blurry, maybe. Okay, should be better. Hope so. So yeah, I read a bit about this deck, and I read that his first edition of this deck was only 26 copies. It was really tiny, but then he, that there were new editions, and he kept working on this deck. The whole idea was to create, not to restore a particular deck, like it's in case of, for example, Dr. Joao Pandolf's CBD, Tarot de Marseille, that is a restoration of a convert deck, but to create a deck that would be perfect for him. And it so happened that so many other people loved his work so much that they also wanted a copy for themselves. And I'm blurry again, am I? Sorry, my camera is like that. I need to do the adjusting manually, and I'm short-sighted to it, so I'm not exactly sure. If I'm blurry, I really apologize. But yeah, what I wanted to say, this version that I have is a fifth edition, and what we get inside, we get this. We get this sturdy box. This is the bottom of the box. I love those boxes. Really, I prefer them so much to those regular thin tuck boxes. I just can easily store my cards here, and it's so easy to open it. I love it. So good move, good move here. Other than 78 cards, we get one blank card. If you happen to lose a card, you can replace it, and a presentation card. So what I wanted to say first, it's a great size. I don't have huge hands, and it's often a problem with tarot decks that it's just hard to handle them. This is not the case here. And this is so thin because I separated. I put the cards in order for you. So maybe I will just start showing you the cards and talk what I want to say, because yeah. So we start with the majors. So I love the size, and I love the colors. As you can see, actually, I have any other cards to compare. Maybe this one. So the background is actually this aged look. I love the papess. She's lovely. So these are, this is the regular white of a card. This is my Lenormand. So yeah, you can tell this is a lovely aged color. It, I don't know, it somehow makes me feel it's more welcoming, it's warmer. And yeah, they shuffle like a dream. Oh my goodness, this deck is so, woo! It's a great cardstock, and many people praise it. So it's very, very good. And what else I wanted to say? Oh yeah, you can read from the box that it won award for 2013 as a historical deck of the year. I'm not surprised. So yeah, what I also did to this deck, and I hope Pablo won't hate me for this, but I mentioned this in my previous video about alteration of the decks, but yeah, I edged this deck. I made the edges match the backgrounds and the backs here. Yeah, these are the backs, by the way. So now I find it's perfect, because you know, when it's machine cut, well, it's just regular, not regular, it's just color of the paper, right? It was white here, and I used the distressed ink, famous antique linen on it, and the result is, in my opinion, it's just perfect. It matches so well. I hope you can see them right. See, the colors are very subtle. I love those blues here, and as I said, the whole feel is very, very welcoming. Like, I don't know how to put it into words. Maybe intimate, like an intimate atmosphere is created by the choice of colors. Oh, this card is so awesome. And I actually have something more to say about this. Should I start with it? Well, maybe I'll just put it there for later. Well, I'll show you all the cards. Pablo's goal was not to create a restoration deck, but as I said, to create a perfect Tarot de Marseille that would work the best for him. And that's the World card. But it is definitely a Tarot de Marseille type 2. And about those types, I just made a quick tutorial to tell apart the type 1 and type 2, so you can check it out. These are the batons. So it is a Tarot de Marseille type 2, just made out of his many inspirations with with various Tarot de Marseille decks. So from what I know, there's a lot of Convert deck influence in the court cards. I will soon show you the Court of Batons. The faces are so interesting. So Pablo said it's like 90% is convert influence in the court cards. Then we get the cops. I wonder, I did not ask him about this birdie, but it's so cute. Did he find it in some deck, or is it his invention? I wonder. But yeah, it's cute. And Ace of Cups is one of my all-time favorite cards in Tarot de Marseille. Wonderful. So among his inspirations were such decks as Pierre Madenis, as Chausson, Payen, Dodal, and I hope I'm pronouncing them right because I don't know French, Fortier, and there was the inspiration for the pips a lot, for the shape of the pips. And Rochias, hope I'm pronouncing this right, Bernardin and Arnault. So as you can see, it's just he looked at so many decks to combine their like most appealing features in his own deck. So about the cups here, those of you who read the Way of Tarot by Alejandro Jodorowsky and Marianne Costa would know that they were saying stuff about the direction of the lines inside the cups. Is it visible? I hope so. So from 2 to 5 we get this direction, which is explained as receiving from heavens, and the higher numbers were the, can you see it, the opposite. So it was like reaching to more heavenly basically. And yeah, so he told me that that it was based on Grimaud deck, but it was found in an earlier deck of Arnault. So this is all like based in the Tarot de Marseille tradition. And there was one card I wanted to show. Yeah, there are so many details, like you will find that in Seven of Cups, this one, this part is not colored. And I'm pretty sure it's not a mistake, it's on purpose, because he told me about this card. So please pay attention of, this is the Eight of Cups. Please pay attention to the handles of these two cups. So here we have red and yellow, and red and yellow. So they are like maybe like mirror images of each other. Like he said that they are saying, you are me and I am you. So in all those details, you can see all the love and passion put into this deck, and all the thought put into this deck. It's not like you would think, okay, it's nothing interesting. It's some cups and flowers. No. It's really, really filled with deep thought here. And then we have the coins. Oh, I love the Ace of Coins. It's lovely. And the Two of Coins, oh, of course. I love me some Two of Coins. They are one of the most beautiful, usually, in the Marseille decks. So, Pablo also told me that some of those flowers have, let's see, some of them have a dot in the middle of this red circle. Yeah, the birdie burning, ouch. And some don't. So he sees that, you see, those have them. And so he sees them like the ace is this with the whole, it's filled with those seeds, and they are just spread through the deck. And some of the flowers got the seeds, some are not fertile and they didn't get the seeds. So that's how he sees them. Oh, I love Six of Coins. And what's interesting on this presentation card, you can see The three of the flowers have dots and this one doesn't. See that? See that? I wouldn't pay attention to that if he didn't talk about those flowers to me before. So yeah. They're so beautiful. And they are not perfect, you know. You probably can see that the coloring is not filling the coin absolutely. It leaves some white spaces, and I love the shade here. It's changing the gradient. It's very, very beautiful. And then the court cards. So yeah, I love the Queen of Coins. I have so many favorite cards. Something very coins. And lastly, we get the Swords. So I will also, oh yeah, Two of Swords again, another favorite of mine. Twos are basically one of my favorites in the pips. Maybe I'm not the greatest fan of Two of Wands, but it's also nice. Yeah, the Three of Swords is also beautiful with those laurel branches here. And we're getting to another point. So with the Swords, the Nine is important here. So as you can see, those red fillings form a heart here and here. So it's Pablo said it's a detail from the courtier's deck. And it depends whether the sword is pointing into you, then it's piercing your heart, or maybe this is your heart and you're piercing someone else's. And the Ten of Swords and the Quartz. Yeah. His face is so, what else? I'm cool. But yeah, the face also like the expression of the face also depends on, well, the expression, how we read the expression, it depends on what we think the situation in the cards is. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this. I will just finish with one suggestion from Pablo, who wrote that if you can, pour yourself a glass of wine, sit with the cards for like half an hour, just look at them, just closely contemplate them, and you will get to know the deck really well. So I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, please write them in the comments. And thank you so much for watching. Bye! And of course, I forgot the Devil. Man! So this is an awesome card. And all, like, our chatting with Pablo started from him commenting on one Tarot de Marseille group that this card was inspired actually by, it's not like he made up all those details. He just saw this Devil card in Jacques Rochias deck from 1782, published in Switzerland, by the way. That's where I live. So I will try and put the original card here so you can see the Devil in the historical deck has snakes, or maybe here snakes, snakes in his hand, and here we just have other details from that card, because maybe the snakes would not, it would be maybe too weird not matching with all the other images from other cards. So yeah, that's where the inspiration came from, and I think it's one of the most interesting cards in this deck. So yeah, that's the devil for you.